VS Code is a very popular code editor, or IDE. The distinction between the two is very hazy. And with it being open source, you're going to see both soft and hard forks, most notably things like VS Codium, which is basically just VS Code, but gets rid of a lot of the Microsofty stuff, makes some nice changes out of the box, and is just... It's basically just VS Code, nothing really too special. And more recently, things like Cursor, the AI code editor. If you see anyone vibe coding, very likely using a tool like this. Now, if you're a C/C++ developer, you are very likely using this extension, C/C++ by Microsoft. This provides all of the nice debugging, IntelliSense, code completion stuff that modern developers, not even just modern developers, developers for the past 20 or so years have expected to see. Not everyone is going to code like Rene Reeb does. Now, installing it over on VS Codium has been a little bit funky for quite a while now. Since 2020, C/C++ extension can't be installed. So VS Codium offers what looks like the VS Code plugin store, but due to licensing changes that happened at the time, certain things could not be included without, you know, Microsoft's lawyers knocking on your door, and most people don't really want to see that. However, the plugin file is offered directly for download over on the VS Code CPP Tools release page, right down here, the VSIX, and there are different ones for different kinds of systems. And with this, even though the plugin couldn't be included in the plugin store, it could be directly installed inside VS Codium. Could be installed inside VS Codium. Has the VS Code C/C++ extension been blocked? Over on the VS Codium repo, Microsoft C/C++ extension appears to no longer support unofficial forks of VS Code. And this happened as of the release I just showed you, 1.24.5. As is absolutely unsurprising, there is literally zero mention of this change being made, this actually being enforced, anything that would happen that would break third-party versions. So, the C/C++ extension may only be used with Microsoft Visual Studio, Visual Studio for Mac, Visual Studio Code, Azure DevOps, Team Foundation Server, and successor Microsoft products and services to develop and test your applications. This did not appear previously when using the extension. This is a new error message. This could not be cancelled out of and it would just work. This stopped it from functioning. I realize this is not the fault of VS Codium. Now, technically it is, okay? Technically, using the extension with VS Codium was never actually allowed. The enforcement of the license, though, that is Microsoft's fault. But I figured I'd bring this to the devs team attention, since this seems like a pretty severe issue, and I haven't seen any other mention of it in this repo or the repo of the C/C++ extension. I found one other mention of this issue on another project, that being the one over in Cursor. This is the exact same issue with the exact same text. They are both based on VS Code. They are unofficial forks. Might also be related to the following discussion, but it was created about a week ago, and this new issue has only presented itself to me today, April 4th, after the extension was updated. This is over on the VS Codium repo again. Are Microsoft made extensions not supported? Technically, they never were. It's just Microsoft didn't care before. For now, I've downgraded to the previous version, 1.23.6, and disabled auto update. Hopefully, something can be done to remedy this. This appears to continue to be working. Whether it will into the future, if there'll come a point where the extension doesn't work with newer versions of VS Codium. But if you desperately need it right now, that is gonna do it. Now, as you'd expect from something like this happening, and there being a review page available, of course, people are going to ask, hey, what's going on here? the classic Microsoft approach of embrace, extend, extinguish. There's no embrace, extend, extinguish. They literally made the extension, so that doesn't actually make sense in this context. Be open, allowing this extension to rub on code forks to get rid of the gross overstepping telemetry. Then once people switch away from other tools, you lock them into the Microsoft branded release so that they can gobble up your data. Microsoft's response, which I don't know who at Microsoft thought responding to this was a good idea. Don't respond to people in the reviews. Never a good idea. We're sorry that you felt upset when we began to enforce our license terms. Like, again, like, why are we writing this? Just don't say anything. This is just fuel for the fire, and I'm happy to start it. Using this extension outside the Microsoft branded version of VS Code has always been a violation of the license terms. For what it's worth, if our data collection is your only concern with using VS Code, it is possible to opt out of that. Why are we responding, Microsoft? What are we doing here? What do you think you're doing? Which intern is managing this account right now? Now, here's the thing, right? It's not like the license terms are being forced on Microsoft where they have to do it because some third party is saying, hey, this software is being used in your thing. You need to enforce the license terms so other people aren't using it. That's not what's happening here. What is happening here is Microsoft made the license terms, then they decide to enforce them. Like, Microsoft is the only party here involved in enforcing the license terms. If they wanted to allow these to exist, they could. There is absolutely no reason why VS Codeium, why Cursor couldn't keep using the extension. There are some theories about why they did so. I've read things like, oh, well, Microsoft is offering their own AI tooling in VS Code, and Cursor is sort of direct competition to that. We don't really have any evidence of why they're doing different things they're doing. Is that a reason I could understand? Absolutely. Cursor is massive, and it's kind of become the default AI programming tooling code editor. And if that ends up being a direct competition with Microsoft, I would understand why they've done so. I won't like it, but I would understand it. And then VS Codeium, well, that's basically collateral damage. Now, as for the license, technically, VS Code CPP Tools, the code base for the extension, is an MIT license code base. Technically. Additional binary files are included in the official VSIX files built and distributed by Microsoft. These are governed by the more restrictive proprietary license found at runtime licenses. In this section right here, there are separate licenses for each of the different components, and these are far more restrictive than what you get. Also, there's a section in, is that French? I think that's French. This is far more restrictive than what you get with the MIT license. This here is when the runtime licenses were added, September 30th, 2020. Now, this report here on September 2nd, 2020 is a little bit before that. However, the licenses were still applied to the repo, although they weren't in the repo itself. It was a separate thing that Microsoft documented as, hey, these licenses are applied, make sure you follow these things, so they couldn't be accessible in the plugin repo available in VS Codeium. Now, here's the fun thing, okay? So now with these extensions not working, turns out Microsoft doesn't just make the C and C++ extension. Here's what someone else had to say. By the way, a similar environment check exists in Pylance, which has prevented it from working with any forks of VS Code for many years. So far, no one seems to have found a solution other than resorting to alternatives. They make a very popular Python extension, which also does not work. You can find that over on the store right here. Now, over on the register, Michael Trill, the co-founder and CEO of Anysphere, the company which makes Cursor, had this to say. Microsoft has a handful of extensions which are closed source. He wrote, pointing to Remote Access, Pylance, C++, and C#. The latest releases of the specific extensions no longer work in Cursor or other non-Microsoft editors. Moving forward, Cursor is transitioning away from these extensions. We are investing in open source alternatives which already exist in the community and will bundle these into the next version to enable a seamless transition. And anything else Microsoft may make which might still be working basically now exists on borrowed time. If you're using it, expect that it will be breaking sometime very soon. Now, in the case of Cursor, they were already doing things in kind of a sketchy way that VS Codeium wasn't. Cursor allegedly has been flouting Microsoft Terms of Service rules for some time now by setting up a reverse proxy to mask its network requests to the endpoints used by the Microsoft Visual Studio Marketplace. This allows Cursor users to install VS Code extensions from Microsoft's market. Other VS Code forks tend to point to OpenVSX, an alternative extension marketplace. This is the one that does not include those Microsoft extensions. As you may expect, the CEO of Cursor did not respond to comment for that one. If this is what they were doing, and this is just allegedly based on what is being said by someone in the GitHub issue tracker, again, I understand why Microsoft went and enforced their terms of service, went and enforced their license. I don't like that they did it because I don't like that this license exists in the first place. But I understand why they did. For about 5 years now, any single day, these extensions should come to an end. There should have been a lot more investment in the truly open source toolchains, because whilst we can look at these extensions and say, oh, it's got an MIT license, you know, if they're gonna break it so at some point there's a license check in the builds, well, is it really open source? Or is this more like a open washing situation, which, great term. I might need to do a dedicated video on that if I haven't in the past. I don't think I have. Anyway, for C and C++, your best thing to go with is the ClangD extension. This is from LLVM. There is absolutely no chance that this is going to be problematic in the future. Along with this, you can combine this with the ClangTidy for doing linting. This is over on the LLVM website. Now, I don't do C and C++ development, but I've heard a lot of people say this is as good, if not better, than what Microsoft is offering. Now, other ecosystems are gonna have their own individual tooling. You're gonna have to go and look at those ones to find what those are. Thankfully, a lot of big languages, the extension comes from the project itself, so you're not really in any situation where Microsoft is going to be able to do anything to those. Anything with Microsoft's name directly attached to it, though, you know, be a little bit wary about the future it's going to have. As I said earlier, we don't really know why this happened, and I'm sure there's going to be plenty of speculation. If you have some of that, let me know down below, because I like Microsoft speculation. I like rambling about how Microsoft does stupid things that annoy people and people just keep putting up with it because, I don't know, they really, really, really just like eating shit. Now, I'm a VS Codeium user, so for me, this is kind of annoying, at least for the Python stuff. Python, I actually do write in VS Codeium. Yeah, that's great. I'll probably just look for replacements. I don't really do much in the way of development, so it's not that big of a deal anyway. It's just every so often I go mess around with my Python scripts, and that's pretty much it. I need to do more development. I keep saying that, and then I don't, and then I go watch some anime and play some video games like Expedition 33. Anyway, for those who are developers, let me know what happened with you. Is this a problem for you? Do you use these environments? Do you care at all? Do you care about some of the other extensions, like the remote desktop extension? I'd love to know. So if you like the video, let me know your thoughts down below. If you really like the video and you want to become one of, I need to fix that, these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Silly Bear Pay, link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me. And if you don't use VS Code or VS Codeium or anything in that environment, Let me know what you use. Are you a Vim, Emacs, something else enjoyer? I'd like to know. Yeah.